All of you, welcome back to course of computing. Our today's topic of video is handwritten numeral recognition. So in the last video we understand about one of the application of NFS, that is OCR, optical character recognition. So we understand that in case of OCR, our main intention is to extract the text which is present from the image and store it in an appropriate format and then perform various operations on it. So this is what the main concept of a OCR. Now similar to that OCR, one more application is there, that is handwritten numeral recognition. So in case of OCR, what we have seen that we are recognizing not only the printed text, the text which is displayed on the board, but in case of handwritten numeral recognition we are focusing on the handwritten digit or handwritten letter. Handwritten numeral recognition, that means we are focusing on recognizing, detecting and recognizing a number which is handwritten number. Means it is not a case that we just print the we take a printout where we have printed certain number, that we are not recognizing, but we are recognizing a number which is written with the written by the human being. So let's understand more about handwritten numeral recognition. So we can say that it's a project to recognize any handwritten number efficiently on a computer with the input is either old optical image or currently provided touch input, mouse or pen. Means you can write, you can attach a touchpad and by using which you can just write any number and then try to recognize it. So it's a part of optical character recognition. Optical character recognition consists of both the thing. It can able to detect the text as well as detect the number also, but this handwritten numeral recognition majorly focus on detecting the numbers and handwritten number. This is what the main objective of this handwritten numeral recognition. It's again the field of research in the domain of pattern recognition, image processing, AI and you can say computer vision. Since the handwriting of different person is very different, means most of the people writing in a cursive letter, some of the normal letter, means everyone have different handwriting. So recognizing that number is again one of the important application. We'll discuss what are the applications of handwritten numeral recognition, where it can be useful. So we can say that since the handwriting of different person is different, so building a generalized recognition system that would recognize all the characters with a good reliability is difficult in every application. So this handwritten numeral recognition involves four steps, like that data acquisition, pre-processing, feature extraction and classification. As we have seen in the OCR, that steps are there. So data acquisition means you need to acquire the data, you need to provide the input, because in order to train your model you require a data set. So in that data set you will provide a different image of a digit, handwritten digit, so that you will train the model that this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Means we have digit ranging from 0 to 9. By using that digit 0 to 9 we are making n number of numbers. So it involves four steps: data acquisition, where we'll acquire the data, then pre-processing, suppose our image is not in an appropriate format, its shape is not proper, height, width, then it may be a noisy image, so we try to pre-process it so that we'll bring that image in a appropriate format so that easily it can be understandable by your model, so that after this training process we can provide a testing where model can able to just detect the handwritten text, a handwritten number. Then feature extraction, because if you are using the concept of deep learning, feature extraction is automated, whereas in case of machine learning feature extraction is manual in nature. And finally you need to classify. So we can say digit classification system can be there. So we have digit from 0 to 9. So how does it work? So it works like this. So we are considering MNIST dataset. This MNIST dataset consists of n number of images, handwritten images. Here you can see 0 to 9 and every digit have different font, means different way. The way of writing a particular digit is very different. So we have this MNIST dataset which consists of a number of handwritten numerals. So we are providing this data set as input to the model for the process of training, so that model can train that this is number 0, this is a 1, miss 1. You can here you can see that one is a single line is 1, slanting is also 1, this is again slanting, this is a dark, this is somehow thin at the top but thick at the bottom, this is a thick, this is totally slanted. So these are the different ways through which we can write a 1. So still we want that our system can able to recognize that yes, this is a digit 1, this is a digit 2, this is digit 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, because all numbers can be formed with the help of digit 0 to 9. So it involves various phases. Just we discuss acquisition of image, pre-treatment, that means image processing, in order to bring your data set in appropriate format so that it can be used by your model for training purpose. Then feature extraction, as I told you that in case of machine learning, features are extracted manually, whereas in deep learning automatic feature extraction will be there. And then finally you need to classify that given number is of 0 or 1 or 9. So we can say it's a multi-class classification problem. Digit recognition is a multi-class classification problem where we are providing a model with images of 0 to 9 handwritten handwritten digit images from 0 to 9. Then we try to train the model, and then we ask the model to classify or to recognize a digit which we have given as a input. So in this way this handwritten numeral recognition works. Then we'll see where exactly this can be useful, where we can use this handwritten numeral recognition. So its major application in a postal, in case of a post office, suppose you are deploying a robot for the delivery of that particular postcard, whatever the parcel that you have. So in that case always we try to write a pin code. So based on the pin code, every city is identified, every area of the city get identified, because in one city different areas are there. So every areas is identified uniquely with the help of a pin code. So pin code play very important role, and most of the time we have seen that a different person have different handwriting, the way of writing is very different. So that robot has to recognize what is that digit, what is a pin code that is written on the envelope, what is a pin code that is written on the parcel. So it has major application in the field of postal code, post office. Then license plate reading can be there. Just I told you that in case of that particular toll plaza, camera is being installed through which you can just identify what is the number of that vehicle. And again, nowadays we have in toll plaza, we don't have to pay the toll directly. FASTag will be used. So how FASTag will work? With the help of camera, it will capture the image, it will recognize that what is the number of that particular car, and just deduct the amount from your account. So in this way the FASTag works. So license plate reading is also one of the application, means where you can use handwritten numeral recognition, means their application can be there. Then price recognition, in case of shop, multiple groceries is there. So on that grocery box there will be a price is written. Suppose we have deployed the a robot at a particular grocery shop, and just go to that grocery shop and ask that give me red label tea, and then he will ask that robot what is the price of that. So robot has to detect the price which is written on the box and recognize it, and can able to tell to the customer, so that customer can pay the money. So price recognition, the price which is written on the box can be recognized. So there also we can use this handwritten numeral recognition. Then recognition of amount written on the checks, that is again the thing, because the check which we are using in case of a bank, there we have written the date, we have written the amount, check number, then check, every check is having its unique number, so that we have to recognize it. So handwritten numeral recognition is having n number of application in the various domains. So just we have discussed postal code, license plate reading, price recognition, amount writing, recognizing amount written on the check for the bank. So this is how we discuss about the another part of that OCR, that is handwritten numeral recognition. No matter OCR works for this, but the special, this is a field that is handwritten numeral recognition. In this case, we are targeting only on the number, but we are not targeting on the text. But OCR not only targets text, but also target about the numbers. But in handwritten numeral recognition, we are focusing on numbers only. So I hope you understand how handwritten numeral recognition works. Thank you.